Swiss banking group UBS planning to cut more than half of Credit Suisse's workforce as part of its takeover deal. Bloomberg reports bankers, traders, support staff in Credit Suisse's investment banking in London, New York, and in some parts of Asia are expected to bear the brunt. Credit Suisse had a staff of around 45,000 before it nearly collapsed. Combined, the two groups have around 120,000 employees. UBS intends to eventually reduce this number by about 30% or 35,000 people. Russia executed 77 of civilian detainees during its more than year-long invasion of Ukraine. Now, the United Nations reported that Tuesday, asserting that such acts constitute war crimes. The UN added it recorded more than 800 cases of arbitrary detention by Moscow. It also stated Russian forces tortured most of the detainees, some of whom were even sexually abused. The report is based on about 1,000 interviews with victims and witnesses and several visits to detention facilities. Russian mercenary leader Yevgeny Prigozhin, whose mercenary group attempted to topple Moscow's military leadership, now in exile in Belarus. That's according to Belarusian President Alexander Lukashenko, who brokered a deal with the Wagner chief to end the armed mutiny. Lukashenko also revealed he convinced his longtime ally, Russian President Vladimir Putin, not to kill Prigozhin after he said he is willing to take in the exiled rebels. This development comes as reports surface charges against Wagner will be dropped. Russian news agencies say Russia's Federal Security Service closed the case after the group ceased their plan of an alleged mutiny.